In this video, we'll take a look at how to run the one-way ANOVA in SPSS. ANOVA stands for Analysis of Variance, and it's similar to the Independent Samples t-test in that it is used to compare independent or unrelated groups. But where the Independent Samples t compares only two groups, the ANOVA can be used to compare 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or more groups, as many as you need to test. And on your screen, you see an example where we have two variables. We have volume and exam scores. And we used a similar example when we conducted the Independent Samples t-test. In this example, what I've done is I've added a third group to help underscore the relationship between these two tests. And let me show you what I mean here. First of all, we have our exam scores variable, as I said, where we have the scores on the exam. This is also known as our dependent variable. And then we have our other variable, volume, where as we take a look at this variable, you can see there's three groups where we have ones, twos, and threes. Now, if you recall, the Independent Samples t-test had two groups, as I'd said before, and we had ones and twos in our variable, our grouping variable. This is also known as our independent variable, the variable that separates or divides people into different groups. This would be what would be required for the t-test. Ones and twos. But as we have a third group here, notice how we added threes for the third group. And if you had a fourth group, you would add fours, and so on. Fives for fifth group, etc. Now, in this study, what we had was, we had a no music group, and then, as was the case with the independent T, we also had a high volume group. But we added another group, and that was a low volume group. So as a reminder as to the background of this study, we had people who listened to either they had no volume, they had low volume now, that's our new condition, or they had high volume playing while they were studying. And then the next day they took the exam, and these once again are their exam scores. So we'll use the ANOVA to see if there's a significant difference between these groups, our ones, twos, and threes, or our no volume, low volume, and high volume groups. Now the one-way ANOVA, the one-way, stands for one independent variable, where in this example, as I'd said before, the independent variable is volume. And our independent variable consists of three groups, no music, low volume, and high volume. These groups can also be called levels, that's L-E-V-E-L-S. So we have three levels to our independent variable. And when we start doing ANOVAs, we do get this new terminology like levels, which I already mentioned. And we also get, instead of an independent variable, which this variable is, it's an independent variable, we also will use the name factor. And you'll see that when we run the analysis in a minute. There's more than one-way ANOVAs. There's like a two-way ANOVA, for example. And if one-way ANOVA means one independent variable, then you can probably guess what a two-way ANOVA means. That would mean two independent variables, such as we could have volume, and then we could have gender, males and females, and then exam scores. But we're just going to focus on the one-way ANOVA here. So the one-way ANOVA will answer the question, does the volume of background noise while studying for an exam have an impact on exam scores? So we want to know, does volume make a difference? Do people do better in one or more conditions as compared to another? And we'll run this test using alpha 0.05. And it's worth noting as well that the ANOVA, unlike the t-test, which we could do a two-tailed test or a one-tailed test, the ANOVA really is one-tailed by design for our purposes. So we'll just be using a one-tailed test, but that's the way it's set up to be naturally. Hey, one last thing, too, in this design. Of these, we had 30 people in our study, and assume that they were randomly assigned to the three groups. So, whether if I was in the study, for example, whether I received the high volume, low volume, or no volume condition was totally up to chance. Okay, so we have random assignment of people to the respective groups. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at how to run the one-way ANOVA.